I'm very attracted to letters because they communicate and there's a meaning behind. But what really interests me is not so much the meaning, but the feeling that you get from something. And that not necessarily needs to be expressed in a logical way. I feel like I like a lot that surprise factor that can come with something that just seduces you visually. And I like to play with that, with more feelings than meanings. My name is Alex Trochut. I'm from Barcelona. I moved to New York 8 years ago. And I've always been a graphic designer that has been interested in lettering and any sort of image making. My grandfather was a typographer and my father was not. And actually the story of my grandfather, he was a very good typographer in the 40s in Barcelona. Somehow he was forced to take a career shift, not towards so much of an artistic path, but more towards business. He was not a great businessman, he was more an artist. The moment that I told my dad that I wanted to be a graphic designer, he really did his best to discourage me from that terrible idea. But somehow I ended up doing it and he allowed me to follow my path. Well, I started at Elisava School and I did some time in Berlin in my Erasmus. I was working in Barcelona for 4 years in different studios. And then I relocated to New York 8 years ago. Every time I came here, it felt like a place that it made me feel very alive. It's full of people that come here with the idea of change in a way. They want to become somebody that they wanted to be and somehow was not happening where they were. There's always like this idea of self-improvement in the city, which I really like. For me, there was definitely a sense of freedom that came with this move. And being very open, and I think like New York really made me feel like the person I wanted to be. I enjoy being challenged by the needs of my clients, which are from fashion, music, editorial, and advertising. I find here like a very nice bubble of people around me that inspire me as humans a lot. And I feel like it's a very interesting dynamic where you're always learning with the people that you are around, either creatively or in a human way. I think what really drives my creativity is the idea of discovery, the idea of like finding something new that you haven't found before. There's a surprise factor that is very exciting in the process. So if I have done something a few times, I might be able to do it better, but not necessarily increase that excitement in the process. So at some point I get bored very easy. When I create something for the first time, that's like the best feeling. Not necessarily the best result, but in terms of experience, that's what really drives me when you're like very curious about what it will be once it's done based on your own surprises and accidents. I find inspiration mainly in, you know, art and nature. I think that's where I grab most of my ideas when it comes to visual stuff. Process takes you to that style inspiration or that visual language that it's gonna appear at some point. So I do believe a lot in accidents and the things that you're not fully in control when you create. And that's what I think is kind of like the magic of creativity, that you let your unconscious take control at some point and you're just there witnessing something and you're like, oh, okay, this is beautiful. I feel I created that 100% because I didn't think about it. It just happened. I'm driven by those moments that sort of beauty just comes visit you and you're just there to see it. Back in the days, I was working with only mainly two programs, Illustrator and Photoshop. That was up to 2015. And then after that, I started to dive into 3D. And then the number of software that I've been playing with grew exponentially. So I was very obsessed with the idea of like, learn your tools and go very deep with them. And now I feel like it went from very intensive knowledge and control towards a more extensive sort of like approach to software and technology, where you're just becoming this generalist, where you're tapping into many different things from sculpting to 3D, clothes simulation, texturing, all these other fields. And I'm not like a specialist in any of them, but I feel like that really gives me so much power into the combination of concepts and new possibilities. I was really excited to start working with 3D from a long time. I was close to colleagues like the great guys from Divine and other like 3D studios around me. I always felt like I'm not gonna be able to learn this software. It's very complicated. That really haunted me for a long time, this idea of like, okay, my creative identity is this box, you already define it, and that's what you have. And then at some point, it was kind of like, it was my studio mate, Freddy Arenas, who just kind of like told me like, oh, don't hire me, I'm just gonna teach you how to do this one thing that you wanna do with a 3D artist, you can do it. And yeah, little by little, I started to learn, and it's been very rewarding since then. The most important thing to start working with 3D with full freedom was to work with a machine that allows you to work with GPU rendering, to render in real time. Switching computer and platform was kind of like mandatory in order to be a 3D artist. Working with a Z4 from HP has really given me that possibility in a very stable way. I trust it, and it's working. Every time I open the software with a new project, there is a lot of chances that it's gonna be very rewarding. There's these sort of never-ending aha moments that are happening all the time with 3D. It's kind of like a very strong connection with your thoughts and how you can represent them in a hyper-real way. So it's never-ending. I think it's for an image maker, it's a super powerful tool. I think 3D kind of like opened up many new possibilities in the world of animation, emotion, and like have in general movement into my work, which it was always something that it was present as an image. But now with 3D, it's kind of like a very easy transition from a static image to something that can be fluidly animated. That definitely probably is the most direct possibility, but also the idea of fabrication. You can model something and then you can translate it as a physical object. The easiest thing that I experienced with 3D lately, it's been VR sculpting, because you're using what your body learned to do all its life, which is using its hands, and like, it's a very basic set of tools. They're just very simple, but you can go as far as you can with your own abilities that you learn all your life. It's interesting of how the software is simplifying itself, and you're using all your abilities as a human inside the digital world, as opposed to softwares like 3D software itself. It's very intimidating, it has a lot of complexity, and it's very hard to control. Like, I feel like craft is something that has lost a little bit of territory in the last years, when so much technology came in and things are very automatic. There's not so much of that human factor. And then VR is really allowing you to bring back that sort of like manual making with a completely digital and 3D way, which is super exciting. Lately, I've been creating a lot with many different kinds of software, from Cinema 4D, rendering with Redshift, and then stepping into other software for like more special needs, like sculpting, like ZBrush, also with Medium, with VR, which is, makes it like so easy to create in a sculptorial way. And Marvelous Designer to create closed simulations, all the substance software like Painter, Designer, and Alchemist. They're very powerful and makes all the shading part very, very fun. It feels like the day doesn't have enough hours to do all the things and that you need to. But yeah, it's definitely a very exciting combination of softwares that are very complementary between them, and they're making them easier and easier these days. So it's a good moment for anybody that wants to step into these new technologies, because they're way less intimidating than they were. With technology, I can, you know, have these superpowers, digital superpowers, that as an artist, they're like incredible. Especially these days, I feel like we are living in this very unique time in creativity, where things that were never possible before are now very achievable and accessible. When I switched to the Z by HP, a Z4, at the beginning I thought it was kind of like a very challenging idea to just leave behind a software and operating system that I've been using for 15 years. In the end, the reality of it wasn't difficult. It was, when I look back in retrospect, it was a very quick switch. And the rewards were like very noticeable and very, very fast. Like, I feel like I'm running with a Formula One car when before I was kind of like going, you know, comfortable, but not at all at the speed that maybe a professional needs to go these days. My current setup right now at the studio is a Z4, which is a workstation. Then I have the amazing Dream Color display, which gives me full accuracy on my color correction. And then I have a printer, which is a Z9 design jet, 24 inches, that makes my life very easy when I need to print my portfolio and show printed pieces. The VR headset from HP, which is the Reverb. It's a great addition. And finally, I have the ZBook Create, which is, you know, my laptop when I move outside of the studio. The ZBook Create is a very exciting, powerful little guy that has a GeForce RTX graphic card, which gives you like the possibility of rendering wherever you are. It's a very compact, small machine. It's not heavy and really makes for a 3D artist the possibility of like render from everywhere. And if you are also a VR user, you could also use it. It's a very exciting tool for just being mobile. Your studio could be reduced to a laptop in a way. So in my case, makes my weekends very easy. Well, I think the biggest benefit of having a ZBook Create is the possibility of not having to say no to any project. This happens to me all the time. The moment that I decide to go on holiday is when projects came in. It's like almost, if I don't have a project, I'm just gonna go holiday and then projects come in. Having this guy allows me to be able to say yes to those things and move around and be able to manage my life, which is in the end, I never fully disconnect. That's the reality and I learned to accept it. Having that possibility makes my stress level be very reduced because there's nothing worse to be out there and not being able to provide with what you can do because you don't have the machine that allows you to do that. So I've been an HP ambassador for the last 3 years. This really opened up a very great relationship with the brand and access to a technology that was not available to me. This really opened up many possibilities. So I feel like my creative identity has really expanded since I started to allow myself to dive into these new sort of territories of technology. It's very fascinating because you keep learning and growing through the possibilities of newer and more exciting technology every day. I'm very happy with the way that I can just express myself very freely these days.